Let's have a look at the training targets. VHDL implementation. We will write and understand a practical VHDL module for LED control. This training tries to show how you can easily add your VHDL code in IP block design by adding it as a module. Explore the ZCU104 carrier card resources and learn proper I/O planning and pin assignments. Understanding clock management by using clocking wizard. Understanding how to apply synchronized reset by using a processor system reset IP. We intentionally avoid the processing system to work directly with the programmable logic. The final design involves running the bitstream on the ZCU104 board, which enables the LEDs to blink in a circular pattern. You can change the direction of the blinking using the push buttons, as well as stop and reset the blinking using the designated reset buttons. Block diagram of design. Let's start from the left side and follow the signal path. First, notice the IDT clock generator. This is our primary clock source on the board. It connects to our clocking wizard through two pins, AH17 and AH18. Clocking wizard helps us generate a clean, stable 100 MHz clock that our LED shifter module can use reliably. You can watch our previous video for complete explanation of clocking wizard. Looking at the input buttons, we have three push buttons, SW17, connected to the reset input of the processor system reset. This unit provides a synchronized reset for VHDL module. Pressing SW17 resets the LED shift pattern and direction to default values. SW14, this push button is connected to the button left input of the LED shifter module. Pressing SW14 changes the shift direction to left. SW15, this push button is connected to the button right input of the LED shifter module. Pressing SW15 changes the shift direction to right. LED shifter module. This module is the core logic controlling the LEDs based on the push button inputs and the 100 MHz clock. LED outputs. These signals control the state of the four LEDs. The LED states shift in a circular pattern with each 250 milliseconds interval based on the selected direction. In the block diagram, the reset pin of the clocking wizard is connected to the SW20 push button. When this button is pressed, the clocking wizard enters reset mode, stopping the clock output. As a result, the LED shifting operation halts since there is no clock signal driving the LED shifter module. LED shifter VHDL code review. Entity declaration. The LED shifter entity includes a generic parameter counter max set to 25 million to create a 250 milliseconds delay with a 100 MHz clock. It has four ports, clock for the 100 MHz clock signal, reset to reset the LED shift direction and states, button left and right to toggle the shift direction with a single press, and LEDs to control the 4-bit output. Architecture signals and processes. The LED register signal holds the LED state as a 4-bit vector, while counter counts clock cycles to time each LED shift. Shift enable goes high when the counter reaches counter max, enabling a shift every 250 milliseconds. Shift direction stores the selected direction, 0 for right and 1 for left. Processes for timing, direction control, and shifting. The counter process controls timing. As the clock cycles, the counter increments, triggering shift, enable every 250 milliseconds to allow an LED shift. The direction control process changes direction based on button presses. Button presses toggle the direction, with each button press detected and saved. The LED shift process shifts the LEDs based on shift enable and shift direction. When reset is high, LED register initializes to 1. A left or right shift is performed based on shift direction whenever shift enable is high. Output assignment. The LED's output is assigned the current state of LED register, controlling the LEDs in a circular shift pattern every 250 milliseconds. The shift direction can be toggled by pressing either button once. The ZCU104 board offers various control and I/O interfaces, including user LEDs, The board has four user LEDs, each located near a push button. In our design, these four LEDs will blink in a circular manner once the bitstream is loaded. The design also includes two push buttons to control the shift direction in the VHDL module. Pressing one of these buttons changes the shift direction to either left or right, depending on which button is pressed. Additionally, two push buttons are used for reset purposes. Clock wizard reset. Holding this button stops the clocking wizard, which in turn halts the LED shifting. VHDL module reset. Pressing this button resets the shift value to its initial state. Let's start to create the Vivado design. Create a new project with ZCU 104 and create a new block design for it. Add programmable differential clock. From the board tab list, add a programmable differential clock. This will add a clock wizard with a differential input and connect it to the appropriate external pins. Add reset. From the board tab list, add a reset and connect it to the reset pin of the clocking wizard. Note that when using the board examples, the board file's presetups are automatically used. For example, based on the board presetups, the differential input is connected to I/O pins AH17 and AH18, which are connected to the 300 MHz clock, and the reset input is connected to the M11 I/O pin, which is the CPU reset push button. Configure the clocking wizard. Double-click on the clocking wizard to open it. Set the output frequency. Go to the Output tab and set the frequency to 100 MHz. Now we are going to add the VHDL code to the Vivado project sources. Click on Add Resource button and then select LED Shifter VHDL file. It will add the VHDL design beside other resources. Right-click on the block design and select Add Module. From provided list, you should be able to select the LED Shifter module. It will add the module to the block design and allows us to work with our VHDL design like a normal IP block. Add a processor system reset block to the design. Connect the slowest sync clock to the output of the clocking wizard. Connect the active high pin of the processor system reset block to the reset pin of the VHDL module, as the reset in the VHDL code is designed as active high. Set the external reset input pin as an external pin. Double-click on the created pin and configure it as active high, as pressing the external push button will pull the pin up. Configure the input pins of the VHDL module as external. Make the LED outputs external as well. Note that the LED output bus has a width greater than zero, so each bit of this bus will become a separate output pin. Connect the clock pin of module to 100 MHz clock. If you directly connect the module's reset pin to external signal, Vivado will raise a critical warning. Let's me try the direct connection of reset to an external pin. As the warning explains, connecting to asynchronous reset source may prevent the design from meeting timing. It means that your design can face with timing error. So let's connect the reset pin to processor system reset and validate again. As you can see, after utilizing the processor system reset, there is no warning anymore. Validate the design and add the top wrapper, and let the Vivado to manage and auto-handle it. Run synthesis design and wait until the synthesis is finished. Open synthesize design and open I/O planning. Assign the proper pin for each bit of LED's bus. assign the proper pin for button left and right. Assign the proper pin for processor reset external pin. Save the I/O setup as a constraint file. This constraint file will be added into the source directory. Now you are ready to generate the bitstream. With our bitstream is ready, it's time to run it on the actual hardware. Before we program the FPGA, we need to set the DIP switches on JTAG mode, which allows us to program the FPGA directly from Vivado. Now, let's download the bitstream into the device over the USB JTAG. First, notice the initial LED pattern. As you can see, the user LEDs are blinking in a circular manner. And watch as it shifts right by default. The 250 milliseconds timing creates this smooth, visible movement. Let's press the left and right button and see how the direction changes. Now, press the VHDL modules reset button. The LEDs will back to its starting position. When the CPU reset is pressed, the clocking wizard is also reset. As long as the push button is held down, the clocking wizard remains in the reset state, preventing any output clocks from being generated, which causes the LEDs to stop blinking. Once the reset is released, the clocking wizard resumes clock generation and the LEDs continue blinking. Thank you for completing this training. If you enjoyed it, please like, subscribe, and share your thoughts in the comments below.